anesthesia and let the neonatal nursing supervisor know that I want to do a full run through. Yes. But we're a little busy up here too. All right, I'll send someone.
Andrews is covering for Lim in the ER. He has a patient who needs a boil lance.
Plastic surgeon can't lance a boil?
Plastic surgeons can, chief surgeons don't. You and Murphy.
What? It was our ideas that convinced you to do the fetal surgery. Now you're punishing us with Andrew's scut work?
We're not getting punished. He is, for being late, again. But I don't trust him alone with a patient. And since you like to defend him and seem to know how to communicate with him, hurry back.
Olivia Hartman?
Yes, ma'am. I mean, doctor.
You're 18?
Yes, ma'am.
Where's the boil?
It's down there.
Down where?
Shaun, it's on her labia.
Hmm. Is it painful?
Like I used a bowling ball for a tampon.
Okay, boil shouldn't hurt that much. Okay, if we take a look?
Okay, if you just scoot down,
put your feet in the stirrups. The swelling is fairly localized.
Extreme pain that's out of proportion to the visible injury could mean you have necrotizing flesh-eating bacteria.
What?
I'm gonna use a heparin preoperatively and a TEE monitor.
Still not enough. The risk of a heart attack or stroke
was thoroughly explained. The patient still wants the surgery.
She wants it, or you want it?
Yes. Saving a fetus's life would be good news for me. Any other questions or insults?
Relax, I'm not insulting you. Of course you want to do the surgery. But you do surgeries like this, some patients are going to die. And then our department success rate goes down, and then our funding goes down, and then you can't do surgeries like this. So if your judgment is clouded in any way, just...
It's not.
Okay.
Sorry, I know this hurts, but I really do need to insert the speculum for this part of the exam.
If I really have what he says, does that mean you have to cut off
my... No. As I said, the abscess is most likely the result of an untreated chlamydia infection. We'll drain the abscess, give you antibiotics, you'll be fine.
Ow! I'm sorry.
The inflamed Bartholin gland is causing the ischiocavernosus muscle to spasm and pinch the labial nerve. You need to start with a more upward angle. Can I try?
I think it's better if I do this.
Ow!
Okay, fine. Can we call your parents? Let them know?
No. I'm 18. I'm an adult.
Even adults need emotional support. Someone to drive them home. After surgery?
I'm gonna take a taxi. I have money.
There's nothing to be embarrassed about.
25% of college students contract an STD before graduation.
I'm not embarrassed. And I know all about STDs. I get tested every 30 days.
There's no necrosis on the vaginal wall or cervix.
You got it in already?
Yes. It's definitely not flesh-eating bacteria. I was wrong.
Thank God.
You do need surgery to drain the Bartholin gland abscess.
Why do you get an STD test every 30 days?
I have to. For work. I do porn.
The umbilical is 19 inches, which will allow us to remove the fetus via cesarean and rest it in its mother's lap while I excise the tumor. Now the hard part will be reinserting the fetus afterwards. We can't overstretch the uterine wall. And we must be certain that every suture is tight enough to handle 4 more months of kicks and thrown elbows.
Do you have a minute?
Can it wait?
No.